Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to go over steps you can use in order to create these layouts. This was an activity that I assigned to my students the other day, and they had to make these six web pages kind of mimic these six basic web page layouts. And first two look like one column layouts. We have a header section, main section, and then we have a header, main section, footer. Then we get to our layouts 3 and 4. Those are two column layouts. And then we have layouts 5 and 6. They are three column layouts. And the good news is once you learn to make some basic 1, 2, and 3 column layouts, you can make any website out there. Practically every site uses a 1, 2, or 3 column layout. All the sites you go to. And so once you make a dozen of these things, you can use the same basic layout for every web project you ever do. But let's go ahead and get cracking on this, and let's see how many we can get done in our first 6 minutes. So I'm going to start working on these first two here, layout 1, layout 2. So let's see, there's my blank page so far. I do have my editor set up, normal stuff in there, meta character encoding, title. I did put a little bit of basic internal styling here just for headline 1, but I'm going to go ahead and create this, and I'm going to use a div ID container. Excuse me. And in real life, I wouldn't have this headline outside of the container. It'd be inside of it, but I think for this demo purposes, that's perfectly fine. I'll have the headline up there. This is layout 1, and I know that this one's going to have a header section. And a main section. Now I know we've got lots of options for these. We could actually use header tags instead of div tags, and we could use section tags instead of div tags and things like that, but that really doesn't make it any easier or tougher. So my goal here is to create this basic layout, and that's what I shall do. I'll go ahead and make a little note to myself though. This is the end of my container. I like putting these comments in because it reminds me what these closing divs are for, you know, because you can get in some web pages, they're really big, and they'll have tons and tons of divs, and it's nice to put little markers in there. Of course, these pages are pretty empty, so the HTML should look pretty simple. But there's my header, there's my main section. Now a little bit of styling for this. I'm going to go to my container. I'm going to give it a border, 10 pixels, solid, really dark gray, so that way we can see it. And then let's see, I've got my header. I'll do a background color that is red, and I'll put a height on it of about 100 pixels. Then I've got my main section. What did I call it? I called it main. I'll do a background color of blue, and I'll go ahead and set a height of 400 or 500 pixels, it looks like. So once again, in the real world, I would set a height on my header, but I likely might not set a height on my main. I like the height to expand to accommodate whatever the content is in there. But when you're making a layout, a mock-up, and there's no text, there's no content, it's nice to throw out some heights so that you can see how they're coming along. And there's my basic layout, header and main section. Let me go ahead and take care of this while I'm here. I'll take all of my text. Instead of that 333, I'll make it an EE so it stands out a little bit more to us. There we go. And let me lower this height a little bit too, just so it fits on my screen a little bit better, so it looks a little bit neater and more organized. There's layout 1. Okay, so that is the first basic layout. And I know I'm using slightly different colors. Actually, yeah, it's pretty close, red and blue. But there's our first one column layout. Alright, next, in fact, oops, I didn't mean to expand that. Next, I guess I'll throw out this three column layout. This should be pretty easy to do, right? So if I jump over to my editor, I'll just do a file save as layout2.html, and this one has a footer. Once again, you could use a footer tag for this, footer, you know, but I'll stick with a div tag just to be consistent here. Very, very common. A little bit old school, I suppose, using divs when I could use footer tags and header tags. And then it's really just making a rule for my footer. I'll do a background color That is green. And I will set a height on this one. If I can spell the word height. H-E-I-G-H-T. There we go. And I'll just do 100 pixels there. Close that off. I'll reduce the height of this main to 3. Save this, run, launch in Firefox, and there's my one column three, you know, my one column layout with header, main section, and footer. So don't think because it's one column it's super simple and should never be done for a real website. You know, our good folks at Apple, they are demonstrating a pretty popular and nice looking one column web page layout. Yeah, you can argue that they got these four sections side by side here, but overall their site is following a typical one column layout. Another one of my favorite websites, over at Zipcar. You might start to argue they've got a two column layout. Yes, their header kind of spans all the way across the top, and their footer spans all the way across the bottom, but their main section is divided up into two noticeable parts. However, I could certainly be convinced by a web developer that, you know, I would still call this a one-column layout, even though they have two side-by-side sections in the main. So you could say this is a one-column layout also, if you were so inclined. So, nothing wrong with the one column layout. Ooh, I forgot to change my title on my layout 2. So I will go ahead and take care of that. Layout 2 and save. Refresh. Oh, I got to change my headline also. Let's go back and do that. There's layout 2 and save and refresh. Okay, so those are my first two layouts, and I'll start up another video and tackle the others.